Bristol Community College Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.2, Problem 7. This is problem number 7 from Section 1.2. It says, for a common type of Goodyear all-season radial tire, the supply equation is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.7Q plus 40, and the demand equation is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.3Q plus 100. And based on this information, there are 5 separate questions that are asked. And the first of these 5 is, part A, at a price of $61, what quantity of these tires will be supplied? So because the question mentions supply, I will choose the supply equation, the one with the S in it. So the supply equation is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.7Q plus 40. Now the S parentheses Q is in there to identify this as the supply equation as opposed to the demand equation. Once I know I'm working with the correct equation, I choose not to write the extra part. I'm just going to simplify it a little bit and put P equals 0.7Q plus 40. So now part A says at a price of $61, what quantity will be supplied? So the 61 will go in for P. 61 is a price, P is a price, and I'll solve for Q. Q is a quantity. So P equals becomes 61 equals, because the price is 61 for this part of the question, 0.7Q plus 40. So now I want to solve for Q. So let me start by moving the 40 here over to the left side. So to do that, I'm going to go minus 40 on both the right side and the left side of the equation. On the left, positive 61 and negative 40 will give me positive 21 equals 0.7Q. The positive 40 and negative 40 cancel out. So now to solve for Q, I want to divide out the 0.7. So I'll have 21 divided by 0.7 equals 0.7Q divided by 0.7. I divide everything in the equation by 0.7. Now on the left, you might not be able to do this comfortably in your head, so just use your calculator. 21 divided by 0.7 equals, and the calculator will tell you 30. The right side you don't need a calculator for, 0.7 over 0.7 will cancel. So 30 equals Q. So if the price is $61 per tire, the quantity supplied, the amount supplied by the manufacturer, will be 30 tires. Part B of this question is, if a quantity of 61 tires is supplied, what was the price? So again, because it says supply, we start with the supply equation, which is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.7Q plus 40. And like with part A, this S parentheses Q is just part of this equation to distinguish it from demand. The S is for supply. This question asks about supply, so I choose this equation. Once I've chosen the correct equation, I don't need that middle part. It makes the equation seem more complicated and confusing than it really is. Once I know I have the right equation, I'm just going to write it as P equals 0.7Q plus 40. Now the information they're giving you, 61 tires, is a quantity. So now the 61 goes in for Q, and now I'm going to solve for P, the price. So P is equal to 0.7 times Q becomes 0.7 times 61 plus 40. So now I'm going to multiply 0.7 times 61 is going to be 42.7. You might need to use your calculator for that, but that is the result you're going to get. You're going to add 40 to that after you multiply. And now when you add 42.7 plus 40 more, it's going to be 82.7. Now, because this is a price, right, P is for price, that 82.7 really means $82.70. The price per tire is going to be $82.70 if the quantity supplied was 61. Now part C, at a price of $61, what quantity of tires will be demanded? So now because it says demand, I'm going to go to the other equation that's given in the problem, which is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.3Q plus 100. And again, the D here is for demand. This part of the equation is just to distinguish this equation from the supply equation. Once I know I've chosen the right one, I don't write this part. And again, I chose this because the question asks for demand, something about demand, so I choose the demand equation instead of the supply equation. Now that I know I have the right equation, I'm just going to write it this way. And now the 61 this time is a price, at a price of 61. What's the quantity? So the 61 will go in for P, and I'll solve for Q. So 61 equals negative 0.3 Q plus 100. Now to solve for Q, I want to start by getting rid of the 100 on the right. So I'm going to do minus 100 on the right, which means I'll have to do minus 100 on the left also. On the left, positive 61 and negative 100 is going to be negative 39. And at first, you might feel that that negative can't be right, but it's okay because the 0.3 is also negative. They're eventually going to cancel by the end of the question. So on the right side of the equation, I have negative 0.3Q, and the positive 100 and negative 100 will cancel. Now I want to divide out the negative 0.3 to leave the Q by itself. So on the left, I'm going to have negative 39 divided by negative 0.3. And on the right, negative 0.3Q over negative 0.3. So on the left, negative 39 divided by negative 0.3, that's 130. That's not something that you might see easily in your head. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. So with your calculator, negative 39 divided by negative 0.3 equals, it's going to be 130. And on the right side, negative 0.3Q over negative 0.3, the negative 0.3s just cancel. So the quantity is 130. So at a price of $61, a quantity of 130 tires will be demanded. So now part D of this question says, if a quantity of 61 tires is demanded, what was the price? So again, because this question asks for demand, I'm going to choose the demand equation as opposed to the supply equation. The demand equation is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.3Q. Plus 100. And again, the D parentheses Q is to distinguish this as being the demand equation as opposed to the supply. Now that I know I've matched up the correct equation, I don't really need the D parentheses Q. I'm just going to shorten it up. It makes the equation seem easier to work with. Now, the 61 in part D here is given as a quantity, so that 61 goes in for Q, and then I'll solve for P. So P equals negative 0.3 times Q becomes times 61 plus 100. So now I can multiply 0.3 times 61. So P equals, it's going to be negative 18.3 plus 100. So now, negative 18.3 and positive 100, I'm going to get P equals, that should be 81.7. Now, this 81.7 is a price, so in reality, it's $81.70. So if shoppers demand a quantity of 61 tires, the price per tire would have come out to $81.70 per tire. And finally, the most important question of all the five parts, part E, what is the market price? What's the market price? What are these tires actually going to sell for? So to find market price, we have to start by saying supply equals demand and figure out when that's going to happen, when the supply equal demand. So the supply equation is given. It is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.7Q plus 40. When will that equal the demand equation, which is also given? And it is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.3Q plus 100. So I've set supply equal to demand. Now, there's so many equal signs in this, it makes it seem overwhelming. The first thing I'll do is I'll say, let's get rid of the S parentheses Q that identifies this as the supply equation, and the D parentheses Q that identifies this as the demand equation. We don't really need that. We don't need to have a P on each side. We can get rid of that. So what this boils down to, what needs to be solved is 0.7Q plus 40 equals negative 0.3Q plus 100. Again, pay attention to that negative. Don't lose that. That makes a big difference. So I'd like to solve for Q. So to start, let me move this negative 0.3Q over to the left. So to accomplish that, I add 0.3Q to both sides of the equation. Now, 0.7Q plus another 0.3Q is 1.0Q, or just Q, 1Q or Q. I still have plus 40 from the left, equals, on the right, negative 0.3Q and positive 0.3Q cancel, and I'm left with 100. Now, to finish solving for Q, take the 40 on the left side and pull it over to the right side of the equal. So to accomplish that, I'm going to go minus 40 on the left, minus 40 on the right. And on the left, I only have Q. And on the right, positive 100, negative 40. I have Q equals 60. Now again, that's right, but it doesn't answer the question. Q is 60. The quantity is 60. But the question didn't ask for the market quantity. The question asked for the market price. So that's right so far, but we're not complete. To find the price, I can take that quantity of 60 and put it either into the quantity for the supply equation or the quantity for the demand equation and solve for P. I should get the same answer either way. I feel that the supply equation is a little bit easier to work with because it doesn't have the negative, though it doesn't make that much of a difference. So I'll choose either one. I'm just going to choose supply. P equals S parentheses Q equals positive 0.7Q plus 40. So again, I don't really need the S parentheses Q. That's just to identify this as the supply equation versus the demand equation. I'm going to write the equation as P equals 0.7Q plus 40. Now, to work with a quantity of 60, I'm going to put in the 60 for Q, and I'll solve for P. So P equals 0.7 times Q becomes 0.7 times 60. I'm going to add 40 to that. So P equals 0.7 times 60 is 42. And I'm going to add another 40. 42 plus 40, P equals 82. And again, that's P, so this 82 would be $82. The market price for these tires is $82 per tire.